I'm going to solve the equation negative 1.5x equals negative 0.6. We can also read this equation as negative 1 and 5 tenths x equals negative 6 tenths. Negative 1.5x means negative 1.5 times x, and therefore the solution to the equation is a value of x that makes the product on the left equal to negative 0.6. To solve for x, we need to isolate x on one side of the equation, and because x is on the left side of the equation, our solution will be in the form x equals some value, again where this value makes this product on the left equal to negative 0.6. And again, because negative 1.5x means negative 1.5 times x, to solve for x we need to undo this multiplication by performing the inverse operation or opposite operation of multiplication. And therefore, to solve for x, we will divide both sides by negative 1.5. Division is the opposite operation of multiplication. So dividing by negative 1.5 on the left will undo the multiplication involving negative 1.5. And whatever operation we perform to the left side of the equation, we must also perform to the right side, so we'll also divide the right side by negative 1.5. Now looking at the left side of the equation, negative 1.5 divided by negative 1.5 is equal to 1, so the left side simplifies to just 1x, but 1x is x. Another way to think of this is, again, dividing by negative 1.5 undoes the multiplication involving negative 1.5, and therefore the left side simplifies perfectly to just x. Now looking at the right side, we need to find this quotient, but notice how we have a negative divided by a negative, which is a positive. Let's write this fraction as positive 0.6 over positive 1.5. And now let's find the quotient on the side. We have 0.6 divided by 1.5. When performing divisions involving decimals, we always want the divisor to be a whole number. To make 1.5 a whole number, we would have to multiply by 10, which is the same as moving the decimal point to the right one place to here. And we can do this as long as we do the same to the dividend. So if we multiply the dividend by 10, that's the same as moving the decimal point to the right one place to here. And now before dividing, we'll move the decimal point up into the quotient, and now we'll divide like we normally do. So we first need to determine how many 15s there are in 6. Well, there are 0 15s in 6. 0 times 15 is 0, and we subtract. 6 minus 0 is 6. Because we're trying to find the quotient as a decimal, we need to keep dividing. To do this, we'll add a 0 to the right of the decimal point in the dividend here. Because of the decimal point, we're not changing the value of the dividend by placing a 0 here. Now we can bring the 0 down and determine how many 15s in 60. Well, 2 times 15 is 30, and therefore 4 times 15 is exactly 60. So there are exactly 4 15s in 60. Checking our multiplication, we'd have 4 times 5, which is 20. So we put the 2 in the tens place value. 4 times 1 is 4, plus 2 is 6. Notice when we subtract, the difference is 0, and therefore we're done. Our quotient is 0.4, and therefore our solution is x equals 0.4, or 4 tenths. Before we go, though, let's check our solution by substituting 0.4 for x in the original equation to make sure it satisfies the equation. Performing the substitution, we would have negative 1.5 times 0.4 equals negative 0.6. Let's check this product on the calculator. Negative 1.5 times 0.4 is equal to negative 0.6, or negative 0.6. So this shows our solution is correct. I hope you found this helpful.